So what does it mean to solve a smaller version of the same problem? Well, often a big, complex, multi-step task is made much simpler by simply just doing each small part of the task one at a time. Or, instead of doing a very complicated problem about 1,000 particular objects, make it a smaller number of objects and see what happens. So what I mean by this, let me give you a very simple problem. The question is, arrange 6 pencils on a tabletop so that each pencil touches each of the other 5. Alright, so I've got pencils like here, so this is a marker, but I want to arrange 6 pencils on a table so that each touches the other. Alright, that seems pretty complex actually. In fact, if you get out 6 pencils, this is pretty hard. So what I'll do is I'll solve a smaller version of that problem. Namely, can I do it for a smaller number of pencils? In fact, it's very funny, people often go to not quite the smallest thing possibly do. Let's do it for 1 pencil. Can I put 1 pencil on a table so it touches each and every other pencil? Well, not much to do there. Yes. Okay, case n equals 1, doable. Case n equals 2, can I arrange 2 pencils on a tabletop so that each touches the other? You bet. Okay, case n equals 2, solvable. Getting a feel for the problem, I want to get up to n equals 6 pencils. Can I do 3? Okay, whoops, if it just touches, yep. I'm going to do 3. How about 4? Now, 4 is not the problem I want to do. I want to do 6. But now I've got a challenge with 4 already. Unless I realize I can put a pencil on top of the ones I've already got. Go up into the 3 dimensions. Brilliant. Now I'm feeling, having had that little epiphany that I can go up a level, then maybe I can do 5, maybe I can do 6. And of course I'm going to wonder, can I also do 7? So playing with smaller versions of a problem can actually lead you to the problem itself. Great stuff. Thanks for watching. For more curriculum inspirations material, go to our website. Lots of great stuff there.